Hi everyone, it's Dr. Romani and welcome back to this YouTube channel on narcissism. I hope that this content helps illuminate what can be a very confusing territory around narcissism and helps you navigate, heal, and recover from these relationships. So, back to my beloved Proverbs. This is one that comes up. I'm sure you've heard this, and this is not a good one, but let's try this proverb on today. If you can't beat them, join them. Ooh, this isn't a good one. And like I said, in the proverb series, we see some of these proverbs are very like, wow, empowering, boy, ancient Greek people understood a lot about narcissism. And then sometimes they're this kind of thing where you're like, ooh, this is not good for us. So let's take this one apart. Now, interestingly, if you can't beat them, join them is a phrase that actually had its origins in political grandstanding, which sounds about right. And it first appeared in the Atlantic magazine back in the 1930s. So in the world of narcissism, all I can say is please completely ignore this proverb and please do not do what this proverb says. Please don't do it. Once several years ago, I was holding an office hour after a night class, and I remember being particularly tired on that evening. As part of that content area in that class, I'd done a short lecture on narcissism. A student came to my office hour. He was actually a business major and was taking my psychology class as an elective. He had listened to the lecture and he said, "Hey, doc, this narcissism thing, if I could figure it out, I would actually be killing it at my marketing job. Doctor, can you teach me how to do this?" I gave a tired chuckle and I said, "Yeah, no, I will not school you in the dark arts of how to be a narcissist. I'm not convinced I could have taught him. I think by the time you're his age, the ship had already sailed." But his point was well taken. Sadly, if we could learn some of these techniques, lose our empathy, be more entitled, be grandiose, be really egocentric, we would likely make much more money, be much more advantaged in our jobs and businesses, and be more sort of successful according to societal standards. We probably also have more time on our hands. Narcissism is in fact an instruction manual for how to get ahead in business. Now, if you follow this instruction manual, you would of course lose friends and hurt and offend people who matter to you and get into some fights and model some really bad behavior for your kids. But you would, as this student clearly hoped, likely sell more things to people who don't need them and get your needs met ahead of everyone else's. So in that way, at least for that student's goals, it would achieve what he wanted. So many people, consistently exhausted by watching the bad folks win, watching them get elected to public office, watching them do really bad things and still get multi-million dollar buyouts and settlements, and watch them never get punished for their transgressions or their crimes, wonder, am I the sucker? Should I be getting on this bandwagon and just do me and do what I need to do and take my half out of the middle and not worry about other people? The answer to that question, both from a societal standpoint and from the point of your mental health, is no. Let's start with society and let's just get that out of the way. The rules of engagement in our world have been pulling for more and more narcissism every day. Social media, reality TV, business monopolies, runaway billionaires, massive income inequity. The more egocentric, entitled, and validation-seeking you are, the more resources you will have. Lots of people in our world can't afford homes, they can't afford school tuitions, they can't afford healthcare, and the only way to feel safe in the world for lots of families is to have more money. And this march towards, well, I can't beat them, this march towards joining them instead of trying to beat them is resulting in more and more problems in the world. Every week, I have more clients saying to me, is it me or is the world more toxic? Now that's an easy question. The world is more toxic. I understand the survivalism that may incentivize narcissism. But the fact of the matter is, it's bad for all of us. The other day, about a week or two or so ago, I ran into a really kind person who was working in a business. It's interesting, back in the day, I would only notice the nasty people. Now, it's the really nice ones who make a strong impression on me because they feel so rare. The scales have tipped. But for a minute, let's screw society, right? Let's focus on you. It's not good for your health to be narcissistic. I don't want you to join them. It means being a chronic malcontent, feeling like everyone is out to get you, to feel constantly empty, to feel like you're always under siege, to not care about others. To not care about others means that you miss the poetry of human relationships. Narcissistic people view kind people as suckers and devalue any show of human goodness. It means losing one of the most important contributors to our mental health. To be narcissistic means losing that. It means losing other people who we care about and who care about us. The research has shown consistently that social support is one of the most important pillars of mental health. Well, no empathy, no support. It doesn't feel good to walk through the world feeling inadequate and insecure and persecuted and having to cover that up by telling everyone, you're so great. It's a lot easier just to know you're good without having to talk about it all the time and not feeling that you need to prove it, and to enjoy the simple pleasure of a reciprocal and loving friendship or relationship, because ultimately those are the folks that live long and healthy lives. It is easy after you are harmed by a narcissistic person to believe that the best path forward is to go to the dark side and stop caring and taking your half out of the middle. It's not good for you. You can't beat them, at least not at their own game. But you can cut off the narcissistic supply. You can stop engaging. You can stop defending and explaining. You can hold on to your reality and take away the power of their gaslighting. When you stop engaging, you actually do beat them. You will never out superficial or out grandiose or out arrogant or out callous or out control them. But you can take away your supply. And then you don't have to join them. You can gently walk away, let them figure it out, and just keep on keeping on as a good, compassionate, and respectful person. Narcissism is a short game, short wins and street fights. Empathy is a long game. It's the lifetime back and forth of loving human relationships and self-reflection. It's the dividends of seeing a friend after 10 years and picking up where you left off, because you've always been there for each other. It's not living in the exhausted state of worrying who's out to get you. It's happily giving of your time because you simply care about someone. It's easier to beat them than you think, but promise me, you will never join them. That may be a nice, sleazy political stratagem, but it is definitely not the stuff of a life well lived. Thanks again.